Going to do is a little practice with three of our vocab terms. Okay, these are the three vocab terms that you'll probably see the most of when we get to quiz time, which is, if I had to guess right now, I would say next week, maybe next Thursday. That's not for sure yet. I'll keep you posted and we'll see. Okay. Speaking of that, whenever I am more confident about when our quiz is going to land, I always make sure that you have a review activity at least a week before that. It's usually right at a week before that. So if over today and tomorrow I'm able to see more clearly that yes, we probably will be ready for a quiz on Thursday, then I'll make sure that by this Thursday you have a review guide. So you have a list of all the things that you'll be responsible for on that quiz. Okay? These are three terms that will probably show up more than other terms on your quiz. So we're going to do some practice with them. I'm just going to show some examples on the screen. We probably don't have to raise a hand and get called on. Just shout out which thing it is. An artifact, a biofact, or a cultural landscape. Okay. Who remembers a decent definition for an artifact? What does that mean? Yeah.
Something found from the past?
Sure. Something that you found from the past. Anything to add to that? Yeah. Yeah, because you could find something from the past that not from humans, right? These are things that are going to help archaeologists learn more about human history. So they're usually things that are from the past that you find. They were also, like Hunter just said, left behind by a person or a group of people. What's a biofact? A little bit different, yeah? Used to be alive. So it's an artifact. It's something that's left behind. It used to have life, okay? Like a pet, something like that. Or a person. And then cultural landscape. What's that one? The odd one out, the one that's a little different. Yeah.
Something that when humans had a relationship with the land, like a building or something.
Yeah. Something that shows what people did with the land or to the land or on the land or in the land. Easy example, just a building. Okay. You can tell that people did something and there it is. Okay. So, again, I throw these up here, just shout out which it would be. So this first thing, a vase or a vase, if you prefer to say vase, because that is kind of fun. An artifact, right? This is a thing. It didn't used to be alive. It has nothing to do with the earth. Well, I shouldn't say nothing, but it's not embedded in the earth. It doesn't serve a function on the earth. Some of its ingredients, or I guess all, came from the earth, but it's a thing. It's an artifact. How's boot? This skull. Biofact. It used to be happy and alive and now it's not. Yeah, I guess it is. Maybe it's still happy. How's about the Washington Monument? Cultural landscape. You can tell that people built something here, right? And even if you imagine some distant future, hopefully really, really, really distant, where we're not around anymore, this would probably survive for a while, or evidence of it would survive for a while. Even thousands of years in the future, you may be able to find that mirrored pool space. You know, it wouldn't be there anymore, but you might be able to see the evidence of it. And the monument might still be up, or part of it. How's about these? Terrace farming. Cultural landscape. So this isn't talking about the buildings, which could be another example, but the farm fields themselves. Does anybody know why some places in the world use this technique? People call it step farming or terrace farming. Does anyone know why? Seems like it'd be a lot of work. There must be a reason. Yeah.
Is it to have layers or to separate stuff?
It's a good idea. Keep things separate from each other to grow things in layers, maybe. Yeah.
Is it for water?
It's related to water, the need for it. Yeah.
They all get about the same amount of water, I guess.
Okay. Maybe it's a way to evenly distribute the things the plants need. Yeah. Oh, that's a good idea. Maybe they're like all the steps are sloped. And so maybe that means you only have to add water in one point and then it distributes. That's cool. Yeah.
To prevent like water to reach them and like if it rains, like it doesn't overflow.
Okay. So maybe this is a way to mitigate the damage of flooding or something. So if it floods, you're only losing the crops on those lower steps or something. Those are all good ideas. This has to do a little bit with some of the things that you guys said. The main thing it has to do with is erosion. Oops. Because this is a way to prevent erosion. It's hard to grow crops on a hillside or on a mountain because of the slope. Because of that slope, when rain falls, dirt is more easily taken away from the side of the mountain or the side of the hill and taken to the bottom of the hill. And you don't want that when you're growing plants, because the roots of the plants need that soil to stay where it is, or else they get weak and they die. So one way to combat that or get around it is to create these steps. That way all the land that you're using to farm is flat, even though it's on a hill. So you're not getting your soil disturbed as much by erosion, just by making these steps. So you see these in hilly places for that reason. Okay, this semi-creepy owl. Artifact, right? Even though it's of something that used to be alive, unless the owl's inside of there, which I don't think he is, then this is an artifact, okay? So even if it's looks like something that used to be alive, it has to actually be the thing to be a biofact. Otherwise, it's just a thing. This is an artifact. Trilobite fossil. Biofact. That trilobite used to be alive. An artifact, right? Fortnite, whatever treasure relic thingy. Llama dude. How about this? Cultural landscape. Yeah, if you're considering the whole picture, the farm field, cultural landscape, right? If that tractor is found in years, that'd be an artifact. If those people all die right now and then they're found later, they'd be biofacts, right? Cool. These tools. Artifacts. They're things. They're not alive. They didn't used to be alive. And even though they're related to the earth, they might be used in the earth. It's not like these have a place where they go in the earth or like they're a building. So they're not a cultural landscape either. Dragonfly fossil, biofact, used to be alive. Serpent mound right here in Ohio. A cultural landscape, evidence of something that people did with the land and this awesome burial mound. And then a megalodon tooth, a biofact, used to go in a living creature's mouth. Nice. Okay, so that's just